you have a M&A background and those kind of things. So let's talk a little bit about that. So let's talk about the industry. One of the things, we're seeing a lot of mergers, and we're seeing some mergers fall through. I haven't confirmed this, but I heard yesterday that the Baylor Scott & White and Memorial Hermann fell through, which wouldn't be a surprise. They're complex deals to put together. I'm actually a displaced CIO from a merger that was successful, and I think is going pretty well. The question I hear all the time is, has this been good? Is this good for healthcare? Is this creating the kind of outcomes we want for, well, let's take it from two perspectives. Is this good for healthcare from a patient perspective is one of the questions. And then the other is, how does scale benefit these large health systems to be able to provide, I don't know, better services for their community?
I think if you look at other industries where M&A work has occurred and consolidation has occurred, in some cases it has been beneficial for patients or consumers in those industries, if you will. It's not always clear that it is. And so, and I think you see evidences of that in healthcare. I believe that most M&A work in healthcare today, especially on the provider side, is driven by the belief that consolidation will enable scale and will enable providers to leverage their know-how across a broader network. They'll be able to serve a broader population of patients and deliver them more services or offer them more capabilities or direct them to the best sources within their network that will over time ultimately lead to better care and also kind of a better financial profile. And I do think there are some evidences of that beginning to succeed. But I also at the same time see that that the health system provider side mergers that take place that don't keep the patient front and center in their investment thesis or in the reason why they do these deals, that it's subject to kind of not have the impact that they're hoping to achieve. And I think, you know, if you kind of then kind of helicopter back just a little bit and say, well, look at all of the other M&A work that's starting to take place around the providers that are doing their own M&A to serve those providers more effectively, I think that's interesting as well.